11-year-old Kristian Gaitan graduated from Washington Heights Elementary School, the achievement represented the first major milestone in his educational journey. On the one hand, it validated his hard work over the last 5 years, but on the other, it served as a reminder that his days of walking the halls of Washington Heights had officially come to an end.
Like, next year you're not going to see your friends, and they're going to be off other schools, and you're going to be to other schools, you know? And I was also getting really emotional, but, you know, it's hard to let your friends go when you've been with them for such a long time.
In the fall, Kristian will attend the Young Men's Leadership Academy, Fort Worth ISD's first single-gender school for boys that boasts a rigorous college preparatory curriculum. His effort at Washington Heights has prepared him for the jump, starting with his third grade enrollment in the school's Gifted and Talented program, offered to students with exceptional academic and creative potential.
Kristian is a very bright, creative young man. When you look at other kids his age and what he is capable of doing, he is above other students.
Kristian's passion for learning extends far beyond the classroom, and when he's not experimenting in the school's science lab, this aspiring chef can be found mixing different ingredients in his kitchen at home.
You just do whatever you want to do with your food, and it's like also science, because it's like variables. You change one thing and, you know, you put another to it and see which one tastes best.
On this day, Kristian, who has mastered his own version of a bacon-wrapped chicken nugget, heads out to swap culinary secrets with John Bonnell, owner and executive chef of Bonnell's Fine Texas Cuisine in Fort Worth. Bonnell's restaurant, which serves everything from wild game specialties to fresh Gulf seafood, is widely considered one of the best in Texas, claiming the honor of the highest food rating in the state by the Zagat survey. Chef Bonnell has also made appearances on national TV shows, including the Food Network's Barbecue with Bobby Flay and the Today Show.
What's going on?
Good,
how we doing?
Hi.
Chef Bonnell.
I'm Kristian.
Kristian, it's nice to meet you.
You too.
You want the quick tour? Take a look around? You've never been here before, have you?
Mm-hmm.
You like to cook?
Alright,
it's going to be fun.
Like the seasoned pro he is, Chef Bonnell gives Kristian the 5-star tour of his restaurant, starting with the front kitchen.
This is where we do all the cooking, right here. There's going to be one guy standing in front of the grill, and he'll cook like 120 pieces of meat and fish and stuff off the grill in one night. No problem. It's kind of hot right here, isn't it? The grill guy just has to be able to take the heat.
On any given night, Bonnell's restaurant can serve as many as 120 guests at one time.
So one guy can handle all these pans and all these burners at the same time.
Wow.
This guy's good. He's fast. One guy will handle just the grill. One guy will make up all the plates and say, okay, I need the quail from you and I need that buffalo from him. And he'll make all the plates over here with different, like, mashed potatoes and sauces and stuff like that. This is where everybody is right now. We're all prepping in the back. In the back kitchen, we do all the big stuff. So he's got this huge pot of sauce that he's making over here. All the big stuff, like cleaning fish and taking huge pieces of meat and cutting into steaks and all that sort of prep work, we do in the back kitchen.
Included in the prep work is the art of shucking oysters.
He's going to shuck them. He's got this glove on his left hand that's giving him a chain mail. You can't cut it.
What's the difference between the rubber one and the...
The rubber glove is just to be clean. The metal glove, you can't cut through. The knife won't cut it.
Look at that.
Isn't that cool?
Wow.
Chain mail.
So it feels weird. It feels like...
It feels weird, but it would... A knife can't get you. Isn't that cool?
Cool.
Next, Chef Bonnell heads outside to show Kristian one of his prized possessions. A must-have for any pitmaster.
This is a serious smoker.
Looks like it, too.
This one's pretty cool. We usually cook right on top of the grill bars like this, but the fire in this one... All the way down at the end. Smoke from this fire comes up through this long chamber and it comes up underneath all the stuff that's in there. Usually, we take this one to like events that we're going to cater, like somebody have a party at their house, and we can cook for like 300 or 400 people on a big one like this.
In addition to the countless food accolades, Bonnell's restaurant also received the Wine Spectator's Award of Excellence from 2004 through 2010 for its first-rate wine list.
This is our wine cell. This is a room just for wines.
Yeah.
There's about 2,000 bottles in here.
The chef even has his own California Chardonnay and Cabernet that bears his name. And he shows Kristian how the restaurant recycles the corks from each of the wine bottles it sells.
They're just bricks. The bricks are pretty hard. So when we had bricks on there, it really echoed and the room got too loud. So we started thinking of stuff we could put on the wall that would be softer, that would absorb some sound, some of the sound waves. And we started thinking cork would work. And I said, we throw away corks every day. Let's just start putting them up there.
With his tour complete, Kristian sees firsthand what it's like to run a kitchen as the first orders of the night begin to filter in.
This is how we keep everything straight. These tickets, I'm looking from the guys who make some of the appetizers and salads and desserts. These tickets are from the hot stuff over here, the entrees. I always take the towels and make sure the edges of the plates are nice and clean.
Mm-hmm.
I finish with just a little touch of an infused truffle oil. That dish is ready to go, and it's going to be right here. So I need a grouper, and I need a side of mushrooms to go with it. My side of mushrooms. The mushrooms also get a little bit of truffle. Put them on a plate like that. Just a little bit of truffle flavor to infuse it. These are mushrooms. That right there is a truffle. One of the most expensive foods in the world.
After working the line, Kristian sits down to sample some of Chef Bonnell's favorites.
So what you got there is venison carpaccio. It's really rare venison with a little bit of green peppercorn dressing. So it's got a little touch of spice, more like a pepper spice, not like, you know, jalapeno spice. This is quail. When you were asking about different game birds, these are just the drumsticks. So there's just one little bone. You can pick them right up. There's a leg and a thigh. There's just one little bone in the middle. And it's a Southwestern buttermilk dip.
A final photo later, and Kristian's night comes to an end.
Make the impossible possible.